StellarIdeas.com, painting with a purpose. This is part of a series of videos of the painting exhibition called Hope, From Robe to Riches. This exhibition tells the story of the journey of Mei Ling, a 19-year-old Chinese woman who travelled from southern China to the goldfields of Victoria in Australia in 1857.
When Mei Ling and Luke eventually arrived at the Canton lead, the situation was under control. The rowdies had been dispersed and the fighting had ended. Sanity was being restored and the camp rebuilt. There were graves lined up along the outer rim of the encampment. Mei Ling was terrified that Shung might be there. She scoured every tent, every campfire, every group of survivors. Her heart felt broken. Luke was with her all the way. It took them hours to cover the whole site. They were exhausted. Finally, Mei Ling found Shung. He'd been beaten unconscious as he tried to protect a significant amount of gold at the center of camp. He was alive. When he woke, Shung was shocked to see his sister, appalled. Apparently his letters had been waylaid. He trusted the most important one to a courier, in which he explained that he was part of the group that discovered the claim, and in the first 3 weeks they'd found 95 kilograms of gold. He'd been there for 6 weeks. There was a great deal more gold to come, so he could not leave. He contacted Uncle and was waiting for him to send someone he could trust to bring the treasure to Melbourne and then on to China to pay the debt. Now it seemed he had two debts to pay and a sister to chaperone safely out of hell, looking like a boy. Then Luke stepped up and promised to accompany the gold with Mei Ling to Uncle's in Melbourne. After he heard the story of their journey from Edenhope, Shung understood that Luke Best was a good young man and agreed to trust his family fortunes to this stranger. At the end of a fortnight of planning and spending time together, Mei Ling and Shung parted company. She and Luke would travel with a battalion of soldiers returning to Ballarat. They would register their family claim, notify authorities of the location of Ping's grave, and continue to Melbourne. The afternoon before she left Shung to return to her parents, Mei Ling climbed the hill behind the camp and looked back across the path she'd travelled to reach her brother. In the distance she saw Mount Ararat. Below this, the sun was peeking through the clouds and lighting up the slope upon which Ping's grave rested. She promised him she would never forget their time together. She told him about the gold. She promised Ping that she would take some home to his family too. Although Mei Ling was sad to say goodbye, she knew one day she would return to Australia. Her heart was full of hope for the future of her family in this wonderful golden land, the new gold mountain, Gum San.